All right, let's get right into it. Tool, The Grudge, another recommendation from you guys. So here we go. There you go. Good start. I like that sound. Somewhere. There you go. I like that. I like when they just jam like this. The jam, you know, just the... That was really, really good. I mean, I was just looking over here on my other laptop, just when this album came out 18 years ago. Judas Priest. That was from the album Lateralis. So this was the... Oops, did I get that right? Stand by. Yes, this is the opening track. What a great opener. And you can imagine putting this on back then in 2001. Putting that in, and the grudge comes on. So Lateralis was a well-received album. The Village Voice only gave it a C, though. USA Today gave it 3.5 out of 4 stars. Rolling Stone gave it 4 out of 5 stars. Q gave it 4 out of 5 stars. Whoa! Pitchfork gave this album 1.9 out of 10. How's that possible? Like, let's check this out. Come on, let's check this out. How do you give an album 1.9 out of 10? Like, just that one song alone. You could have every other song afterwards be complete crap and dud, and you still have to give the album, like, you know, 4 out of 10. Like, there's more in that song than what bands release today. They call themselves musicians. Let's be honest, right? So the Pitchfork is an American online magazine that was launched in 95 by Ryan Schreiber. Sorry for that first name. Based in Chicago and owned by Condé Nast. It's being developed during Schreiber's tenure in a record store at the time. The magazine developed a reputation for its extensive focus on independent music, but has since blah, blah, blah. Okay, so let's check out their review here, guys. Try to find if they talk about The Grudge. Oh, here we go. The first song is called The Grudge, and it's about astrology and how people control stuff. Maynard sings like a robot or clone at the opening, spitting where the, well, you know, the lyrics, blah, blah, blah. Tool know about space and math, and it's pretty complex. Saturn ascends, not 1 but 10, he sings. No Doubt and REM sang out that too, but those songs were wimpy and short. Maynard shows his intelligence with raw stats. I think there's meaning behind those numbers, like calculus. He also mentions prison cell and tear it down and controlling and sinking deeper. Okay, well, this all sounds good. 7 minutes into the song, he does this awesome scream for 24 seconds straight, which I did notice, and I love that. That was awesome. Which is the longest scream this person's ever heard. Then at the end, there's a part where Danny Carey hits every drum he has. Okay, that's good. This wall of drums just pounds you. Then the next song starts, and it's quite quiet and trippy. Tool are the best metal band, since they can get trippy than just really loud. Most bands just do loud, so Tool is more prog. Okay, well, he gave a 1.9 out of 10. Sorry, guys, I'm just trying to find out. Okay, sorry. Well, go check out this link. They gave this album 1.9 out of 10. That's pretty bad. Alright. He didn't like it, though. The problem is Tool defines Opus as taking their defining element, wanking sludge, and stretching it out to the maximum digital capacity of a compact disc. Ooh, so they're saying they draw out their songs too much for drawn out sake. Alright, well, you go to Pitchfork with your pitchforks. Anyways, that song was awesome. Screw Pitchfork. It was an incredible song, and I'm sorry if I wasted your time with that little divergent there at the end there, because I wanted to see what these people had to say about it, because quite frankly that was a really good song. It was a pounding rhythm, pounding drums, great vocals that scream, and I think this is up there in my top two or three Tool songs that I've reviewed out of the five. So yeah, great. It's hard to believe that was 18 years ago. I mean, that could have been released on Fear Inoculum's album and you wouldn't know it was dated 18 years ago. So it shows you that their music is probably pretty timeless, is what I would say. They don't really fall. There's a little bit of a hint of 2000-ish in their sound there, a little bit. You can kind of, it's hard to explain because I'm not really a music nerd, but I could kind of sense a little bit of early 2000s. But that being said, it's just, it's pretty ageless. So great stuff. I like that. The Grudge, great song.